Want an automated way to import your bank information directly into Notion? This is something we've all wanted, especially for tracking finances. Enter Rose. Rose is a powerful spreadsheet tool with a game-changing banking integration feature. Simply connect your bank accounts and watch as your transactions automatically sync to your Notion databases. No more manual data entry needed. In this video, I'll show you how to set up Rose, create a simple finance tracker, add the integration to an existing template, and cover important details about security and pricing. If you find this information useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. To get started with using Rose, first you'll want to make an account and sign in. So we're just going to go ahead and sign in here. Once you're signed in, you can click Create Spreadsheet. The next step is going to be to connect your bank. So we're going to go ahead and go to Import Data From, and we can go to See All, and you should be able to see one that says Bank Accounts. And Rose partners with Plaid, and you can basically access thousands of bank accounts from the US and EU. So we're going to go ahead and click Get Transactions from Your Bank Account and then Connect. And then I'm going to click Connect. Once you have the bank account connected, then you should see something like this, and you can set a date range for how many of the transactions from what period you want to have here. So the last 30 days are going to be entered into this table, and then we can go ahead and click Create Data Table. So now that we have this data here, what we can do is to go ahead and now see how we can connect this to Notion. Before we do that, I would recommend you to go to automation here and then schedule the data refresh. So if you want this information to be refreshed daily, you can turn this on. There's also other options as well, like every hour, every Monday, every first of the month, and so on. And then once you have that on, we can click out. And next we can also check how to connect it to Notion. So we're going to click this X button here, and we're basically going to be adding a new column, and we're going to add a formula. And this formula we're going to name Notion. And basically what we want to do is to add a database page to Notion database. So we're going to connect an account, click connect, select pages. And I'm just going to select them all so that we don't miss any pages. But if you'd like, you can also just give access to certain pages. And now we can start connecting Notion. So add database page to Notion. And then the next step is going to be to add that database to this formula. So let's go ahead and build up that database. So if you have an empty Notion page, you can go ahead and start by typing slash table. And we're just going to build a very simple finance tracker. So let's go ahead and click table view and plus new table. And let's call this Rose integration tracker so we can find it easily. And then what we're going to do is create properties that are going to match with the integration. So we're going to need an amount, a date, description, and it'd be nice to have the category as well as know which account it comes from. So we're going to go ahead and add those. So this name is going to be the description. Then we're going to add a number property here to add the amount. And we can change the number format to US dollar. The next thing we're going to do is to add a date. So we're going to add the date. Then the other thing we need to add is the account. And then we're going to add a category. So this should be sufficient for just this basic finance tracker. We can move the data over here. And let's go ahead and add the data here. So we're going to go back to our rows. And now at the column, we're going to add the link to this database by clicking the three dots here and then copy link to view. We're going to go back to rows, and then we're going to type two quotation marks here and then put the link in between. And then now what we're going to do is to map out the properties. So basically, for example, name, that's going to be the description. Then we have the amount, and that's going to be the amount. Then we also have the category, And that is going to be the personal finance category primary. And we also need to add the date. And that's going to be the date. So this should be everything. And make sure that these are all spelled correctly, the same as your properties inside of Notion. Otherwise, it's not going to load properly. So name, amount, category, and date. And let's double check here. Name, amount, category, date. And we need to add the account. So let's go ahead and add that account. And we're going to add the account. And make sure to delete the extra comma. And now it should work properly. So let's go ahead and click Save All Changes. So now you can see here that it worked and it's a Notion page here. So now let's go ahead and check in the finance checker. And now you can see that it's loaded in here. So you can see everything here. And basically it categorized and it shows the accounts. If you'd like to change these into a select property, you can click here and then edit property and then change the type to select. And that's gonna change it to the account type like this. And then you can do the same here as well. Change the property. So we're gonna edit property and then we are going to change the type into select. And now we see these like this. So it's really important that these match in order for the select or multi-select to sync properly here. And now we can see what kind of things you can do with this information. So basically some things I would recommend is to click here, the three dots, go to group, and you can group it by the date and you can date by month. So this allows you to see your monthly expenses and you can show the newest first. You can also do things like calculate the sum here so you can see the amount. And the other thing you can do by clicking the plus sign here is to add a chart. And you can see it, for example, inside of a donut chart. And you can see it based on category and you can show the sum. So you can see what percentage of the money went to what kinds of categories. So you can really manipulate the data in this way, and it's just a really simple and easy way to track your finances in an automated way. So next, let's talk about how you would connect rows to an existing Notion template. And in this case, I'm going to be using an example from the store called the Ultimate Personal Finance Checker. If you already own this template or if you're interested in it, this is a way to actually add this integration to that template. So the first thing you'll want to do is go to the Ultimate Personal Finance Checker. If you're on another kind of finance tracking template, you'll want to look for the database which logs expenses. So we're going to go ahead and go to databases. Before we do that, however, let's make sure that we have the correct account. So in this case, we have credit card A here, and I'm just going to call this one Quicksilver. So we know that this is the Quicksilver credit card. And once we have that, then we can go to the databases and we want to go to the expense database. Once we're in the expense database, we can do a quick edit to this by adding one extra property so that it's going to work with this integration. So we're going to go to this month just so that you can see this. And I'm going to go ahead and click the plus sign here and I'm going to add account. So the account in this case is a relation database, which you can't really add through this integration. So what we're going to do is we're going to add an automation that's going to tag it to the correct account when it loads. So we just need to add this here for now. The other edit that I'm going to make is to make sure that the categories reflect the categories that we have in here. So in this case, we have this general services. So I'm going to go ahead and go here and go to category, edit property, and I'm gonna make sure to add the different kinds of tags. So these are the categories. You might have more if you're actually using a card that you're using a lot. And now we have this here. So once we have the categories here, and it should be spelled exactly the same, and we have the account, then we can actually start trying to connect them. And one more step before connecting them that you should do is to set up this automation inside of Notion. So if we click this mark here, and this is only for Plus Plan members, but basically you can add a trigger, which is that the account, this one, is going to be called Quicksilver. So this means that when the item comes in here, the account is set to Quicksilver. So if we go here, we can see it's Quicksilver. And then what we're going to do is to add a new action, and that is to edit the payment method. We want the Quicksilver credit card, and we also want to edit the property, which is the status, so that it's actually paid. So we can automatically add these elements when items come into our expenses, and we can create this. So now what we can do, now that everything is set up correctly, is to go to the three dots here, and we are going to get the copy link to by month, and then we're going to go back to rows, and we can click this formula mark here, edit formula, and we're just going to edit this link. So we're going to paste this new link in, and then we can check how the properties are mapped. So name, amount, category, date, and account. And if we check here, basically that's what we have: name, category, amount, account, and date. So everything looks good. And before we click save all changes, one thing we're also going to do is just to check how we're importing the data. So we're going to click these three dots here, edit data table. And I would recommend you to check the sort and filter source and then filter. So with this template, we're only tracking expenses. So that means that we only want to see the amount greater than zero. So we're going to change that to greater than zero and then save changes. So now we've removed all of the values that was negative. And if we go back, we can go to the formula column and we can click save all changes and see what happens. So now if we go to our expenses by month, we'll see all of this here now, and then we can also see it by this month as well. So everything looks good. And if we go back to our main page, you'll also see the expenses here, and you'll see the Quicksilver credit card here as well. And the other thing to note is that particularly for this template, you will have to manually add the monthly tracker, quarterly tracker, and debt payment, and the recurring cost tracker. But at least this part is going to be fully automated, which should be very easy to use. If we go to our income, expense, and transfer here, you can see the expenses by month. And here is where you could potentially add the monthly tracker really quickly, so you can check all of the empty ones in here. Next, let's talk about Rose pricing. So Rose is pretty generous in its free plan because you can at least try it out and see if this would work well for you. So Rose has free, plus, pro, and enterprise. And the differences here are mainly in the amount of, for example, integration executions and also Rose API calls. But it's really good that you can try it out, and also the AI analyst prompts as well. So the Plus plan might be better in terms of using this really regularly. And of course, there's also the Pro and Enterprise if you're using this for business purposes. Next, you might be wondering about Plaid safety and also security, because you don't want to be sharing your financial information and that it got leaked or something. Rose uses something called Plaid, and it's a very secure way to share your financial information, trusted by lots of software and different kinds of platforms. So if you're interested in learning more about that before you trust your bank information, you can check out plaid.com/safety and just read through what kinds of measures are being taken so that your information is secure. I hope that this tutorial was useful. If you're interested in Rose, who's the sponsor of today's video, be sure to check the link in the description. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions or thoughts, and I hope to see you all in the next video.